When you linger in a shady forest, you sometimes look up into the treetops and see a green sea of leaves or needles. The wind rustles through the treetops. But what happens when the rustling falls silent and a tree loses its green? Is the tree then worthless, or is it of great value to the ecosystem in which it once flourished? Then a drumming sounds. The voice of the Deadwood comes to life. But what is Deadwood, and what benefits and functions does it have? In ecology, Deadwood is used as a collective term for dead trees or parts thereof. A rough distinction is made between standing deadwood and fallen deadwood. In primary forests, large volume deadwood is created by the dying of aging trees, catastrophic events such as forest fires, wind throw and lightning strikes. The mass occurrence of insects and other environmental influences, such as fluctuating groundwater levels, also favor the formation of deadwood. Small volume deadwood forms in primeval forests as well as in commercial forests, primarily due to competitive pressure in young stands. This leads to the death of trees that are weak in competition and to the death of branches that no longer receive sufficient light as the bigger trees grow upwards. Depending on the forest community, the proportion of deadwood in the total wood biomass in the primary forest in Central Europe is 10 to 30%. In commercial forests, this proportion is only 1 to 3%. Deadwood has a variety of benefits for ecosystems and their flora and fauna. This is because deadwood is utilized by a variety of organisms. They have adapted to this habitat during evolution. Depending on the type of wood and the degree of decomposition, around 600 species of fungi and around 1,350 species of beetles are involved in the complete decomposition of a wooden body. A wide variety of symbioses exists between fungi and insects. For example, insects transfer fungal spores to the wood, and the fungi can in turn be a source of food for insects. Over the years, dead wood is decomposed by specialized bacteria, beetles and fungi, such as the tinder fungus, the honey fungus and other wood decomposing species. The resulting humus serves as a breeding ground for a new generation of plants. Many animals and plants that depend on deadwood are protected throughout Europe. These include mosses such as Buxbaumia viridis. Deadwood and its biocenosis are good indicators of biodiversity and the naturalness of forest ecosystems. Around a quarter of all species found in forests depend on deadwood. Insects and fungi are the most species-rich groups. Many mosses, lichens, and vertebrates need this substrate to survive. Woodpecker cavities in living or dead trees continue to be used by owls, jackdaws, and other bird species, but also by marmots. Bryophytes play an important role in deadwood ecosystems. Many liverwoods are dependent on deadwood. But also mosses such as Tetraphis pellucida are deadwood inhabitants. It is a 1 to 2 cm high species which forms light green, reddish colored, loose to dense turfs or hand-shaped, large herds. This species often forms terminal gemmary cups which contain gemmae. A gemmae is a cell which separates from its parent and grows into a new individual. Tetraphis pellucida forms upright, symmetrical capsules with a peristome with only four teeth. The species often grows in association with the liverwort Lepidotzia reptans. Its appearing is light green to dirty yellow-green, and it forms coatings pressed against the substrate. Its creeping branches are pinnate and only 1 to 2 cm long and about 1 mm wide. The leaves are divided into 3 to 4 lanceolate lobes on 1/3 or 1/2. Other genera frequently found on deadwood are Lophosia, Calipogea, and Cephalotia. In order for deadwood organisms such as these to survive in the long term, networked deadwood-rich habitats of different sizes are required. Tree trunks and stumps hold the soil together, and those help to reduce soil erosion during heavy rainfall. Research has shown that, under certain circumstances, a spruce forest that has died due to bark beetles takes over the protective function until the new generation of trees is present. This protects against rockfall, avalanches, and erosion. A similar effect can also be seen after windthrow events. If a functional protective forest is thrown down by a storm, the protective effect against avalanche cracks and rockfall is not lost for the time being, but improves. The carbon contained in the wood remains stored in unmanaged forests until the tree dies naturally and rots. The organic material is then mineralized on the one hand and converted into humus on the other. During mineralization, the organic carbon is converted into CO2. The amount of CO2 released is balanced out by the CO2 bound by the wood growth. This is referred to as a system in equilibrium. However, deadwood not only fulfills an important function in forests and other terrestrial ecosystems, but is also of great importance in freshwater ecosystems and semi-terrestrial ecosystems such as bogs. In raised bogs and fens, deadwood makes a decisive contribution to the development of typical site factors. In oxbow lakes and moors, fluctuating groundwater levels and climatic influences also ensure the natural formation of deadwood. Due to the competition between ecological objectives and other human needs and demands on forests, parks, and similar habitats, deadwood is usually removed. Or in general, its formation is counteracted. On the one hand, economic interests, such as forestry, play a fundamental role to protect against damage caused by large-scale insect damage or the risk of forest fires, deadwood is only tolerated in limited quantities. There is a conflict of interests between the ever-increasing demand for energy wood and the ecological promotion of deadwood. The increasing demand for energy and timber could halt or even reverse the trend towards more deadwood. Climate change can also affect and reduce the species richness of deadwood-dwelling moss communities due to a drier and warmer climate. This can lead to a loss of biodiversity, especially in liverworts. Both the preservation of biodiversity and the utilization of renewable energy sources are goals of sustainable development. The challenge in forest habitats is to utilize the renewable resource of wood in such a way that is not at the expense of biodiversity. The preservation and promotion of deadwood is of great benefit to ecosystems with which humanity is closely interwoven.